Hey, what's up, everybody? Video 44 coming at you with another video. All right, so we got the Cleveland Cavaliers in an early Saturday game here in LA against the Lakers. 12:30 Pacific, 3:30 Eastern. Now, I said early, I meant early. Cavaliers have, they've been struggling, man. They brought back Donovan Mitchell about 3 games ago, but he hasn't played very well. I'm wondering if they brought him back too early or if he was just shaking off the rusted time to play us. Either way, Donovan Mitchell tends to go to the line a whole lot against the Lakers when he's right. And that's just something that happens very consistently to us. Very, very consistently. He goes to the line probably as much as anybody that comes against us ever. So that's the first thing I want to say. The second thing I want to say is Jared Allen and Evan Mobley, they're two twin towers. They don't miss very much. Over the last several games, they have shot well above 60% from the field. And we need to understand how talented both of them are. Evan Mobley can defend. He can do everything but shoot the three at a consistent rate. He could pass. He could dunk. He's obviously got fantastic length, rebound. Very dangerous player. And then Evan, Jared Allen, definitely somebody that you have to respect at the rim. One of the better shot blockers in basketball. Both of them are healthy. Makes it pretty dangerous. Darius Garland, also somebody you got to take very seriously. He's been struggling as of late, missed a good majority of the season, as well as Evan Mobley with injury, and is working its way back in. They don't really have their team synergy like you would expect, but this is an all-star in this league, somebody who could stretch the floor, make fantastic plays, just a very dangerous basketball player all the way around. So up-and-coming young star, we need to respect their backcourt and their front court, because they're talented in both of those areas. And Max Strus makes it come together. Played for the Miami Heat last year, was at the NBA Finals, of course. Could shoot the three ball a little bit, although his shooting percentages tend to leave a lot to be desired a lot of the time. He can get hot, but he makes his money doing Swiss Army knife types of things. Rebounding the ball, getting people involved, playing defense. So that's really what you're looking at right now, man. The Cleveland Cavaliers, they don't have much of a bench. A few of their guys are missing off of that bench. And as a result, they're running guys that you probably don't want to see out there. Tristan Thompson, Damian Jones, we know those guys. Dean Wade is out. Isaac Okoro, from what I understand, will likely be out or a game-time decision. And so this Cleveland Cavalier team is a bit depleted. Really, they got a guy by the name of Sam Merrill that they use a lot. He'll probably get some minutes tonight. Marcus Morris Sr. is on his team. You know, they just got an old man bench. Not much young talent being utilized there. And so, for me, we just got to get through that front line of five players that are going to be getting over 32 minutes a game. And after that, you expose their bench, and it's pretty much curtains from there. They don't really have much of a bench, to be honest with you. So, yeah, man, it's Cleveland Cavaliers team. Coming off a loss to the Suns. We really needed them to beat the Suns, but Suns have been beating everybody as of late. And the Cleveland Cavaliers are no exception. They've also lost games to the Denver Nuggets, of course. Jokic went for a triple-double with 18 boards. They killed him on the boards. It's been a lot of losing for a team in the, playoff race in the Eastern Conference. They're not playing their best ball at the right time, unfortunately for them. And I think a lot of that really does have to do with that bench being unreliable for the most part. They got a guy by the name of George Niang that they use quite a bit. Played for Philly last year. He'll be on that bench. If he has a hot night, which he has had in one of the games that they've played recently, it could give them a different dynamic. But, Chris LeVert is on this bench. I don't know if they're using him as much anymore. I really don't know, but I didn't see him in the box store in the last one. I think Larry Nance is hurt. I don't know where Larry Nance is, to be honest with you. I have no idea. I think his brother's on this team now, getting garbage time minutes. I believe that's his brother. It's a new Nance down there. And, you know, that's really what I see with the Cavaliers, man. They just really lean on their starters and hope for the best. That's the God's honest truth. They don't believe in putting together talented young bitches. And I think that would make all the difference for their franchise if they just would just drop half of these old guys and bring in some hopefuls that could run. But can't tell these franchises nothing, man. So it is what it is. We'll be going up against them today in a game we must win. A lot of things went right for our team last night in the standings. Kings loss, Pelly's loss. So we have an opportunity to step forward. We have a tied record with the Kings. Of course, the Kings have the tiebreaker there. But if we win today, we could firmly step ahead of the Kings and get it to an eighth place, which is everything to our franchise right now. Golden State lost last night, so we got even more distance between ourselves and them. We just need to take care of our business. After, you know, going on a 5-1 road trip, finally home, man. Finally home. The Lakers are going to get a little fresh home cooking. They got the fans behind them for this one. Even though it's an early game, I know we'll be ready for it. More so than most 12:30 games because of what's on the line. So, Bron, AD, all those guys are playing. Gabe Vincent, not even on the injury report anymore, so I'd assume he'll be available tonight. Our usual suspects are out. Christian Wood, Vanderbilt. I didn't see anything good with Jalen Hood-Schifino. Of course, he's still out for the season with the back surgery. I'm not really sure what's going on with Cam Reddish. I don't remember if he was on the injury report or not. But that's really what I've seen thus far. And, of course, it's barely 7 a.m., so a lot could change between now and tip-off at 12:30. But that's really what we got going on, man. A date with the Cleveland Cavaliers. We know that's a big thing for LeBron James, obviously. With him coming to town, I'm pretty sure it would be nothing but right for us to get a big game out of the King today and take care of business against his old squad. And so that's what we need to do, man, with only 5 games left. Take care of our business. The standings may fall in our favor, maybe not, but if we take care of winning, things will be all right. So that's what we need to do, man. Step ahead of these Sacramento Kings, get into that play-in tournament top tier, and, you know, see if we could buy ourselves a little bit of a cushion there in these play-in tournament circumstances. And so, with your Lakers playing on a Saturday, of course, they'll be wearing their white uniforms. And the Cleveland Cavaliers are going to be wearing their white and wine and gold uniforms, mostly wine. Pretty nice uniforms, if you ask me. I don't hate those at all. So, yeah, man, that is really what I have to say. Cleveland Cavaliers, I expect to beat them today. I know they got some high-level talent in their starting lineup. And I'm sure they'll lean on those guys quite a bit. But I think we just have a little more to throw at the Cleveland Cavaliers than they have to throw at us. So if we show up, be aware that we tend to play poorly in these 12:30 games. But show up and look to just take it to this team. You know, guys like Rui Hachimura, the way he's been shooting lately, we should be ready to attack. You know, I don't think they have all they need to stop what it is that we're throwing at them. Anthony Davis, Bron James, Rui, D'Lo, Austin. If they all play well, Cleveland should be going home a loser, man. It just is what it is. They're not playing great ball right now, and we need to take advantage of that. And so that's really what it comes down to, man. I hope everybody enjoys this game. Of course, I'll be in transit for the first half of it, so I'm not really sure if I'll be available for the halftime video or not. I likely will be, but just in case you guys have a heads up. But for the end of the game, I'd expect I'll be able to watch that and give you a reaction video afterward. It shouldn't be an issue for that, I don't believe. So that's pretty much it, man. Lakers versus Cavaliers, BDL 44. I thank y'all for watching. I'm out.